effect because the swing takes this long. So people say, what's wrong with my swing? That's why I have these mirrors. I said, the problem isn't with your swing, is that you've committed five errors before you've moved. Okay? Now that could be gripping, that could be positioning of the ball, that could be balancing your body, okay? That could be angles are off. So in that 1 second, your body has to be in a position with your hands to move correctly, okay? So we'll talk about the setup, but right now we understand the face, right? The trick of this game is to hit the ball in the middle. So the problem is you're only playing with about a quarter glued to the middle of your face. That's it. Because you can make some nice swings and hit the ball off the toe, it'll go straight over there. It can hit it off the heel, it can go right over there. But you've made a pretty good swing, but you miss hit the center. That's the tricky part, okay? That takes time. So now we've went up the grip, and now I'm going to talk about the amount of tension that you put in your hands, and how much should that be? 10 being choking the crap out of it, 2 being very loosely hanging on to it. You guys know the answer to that, okay? The poor golfers, there's a school of poor golfers, and they do the same thing all the time. They talk to each other, they always talk bad golf, okay? They misposition their hands, they don't pay attention to the face, they aim it wrong, okay? Then they misposition their hands and they loosely hang on to the club so it moves around with their fingers, okay? So you have to find a way to feel like your hands are kind of duct taped, your fingers are on there. So the fingers are the screws that keep the hinge to the door, okay? Bad golfers love to have the screws loose so the hinge flops around, wondering why the door doesn't slam perfectly shut all the time. So if you ask bad golfers, you say, how much do you hang on to the club? 2. Have you ever tried 10? No, then how do you know what 2 is? Because I know that the club is slipping around in your hands, okay? Now, if I teach golf to a professional hockey player, talking about grip tension, that's a totally different story. Packer up gutter position here, you can see it. So then we place the club up perpendicular or square. Square is a term we use a lot in golf, square. Square is when the toe and the heel is straight up and down, okay? Square is when you bring the club face up to a object like that. They come running at the same time. That's called square. All good golfers talk a lot about square, that they're worried about square. Really worried about it, because that makes the ball go straight. So you understand how to aim the face. You understand how to grip the club, okay? And we'll keep on repeating this stuff, okay? Now you're going to have to come up and position your body in relationship to that gutter, okay? For the guys, it's like a quarterback deal. That's your line of scrimmage, okay? You're going to come up with your feet parallel to this line, okay? Feet are parallel. Bad golfers like to aim. I ask them, I quiz them on aim. They say, I aim my feet, you know, or their shoulders. So those questions you don't want to flunk, okay? You aim what? The club face. So we're aiming the club face at the target, and our body is going to be positioned parallel to that line, okay? Now your posture, as the handicaps go up, okay, they hear things like, I'm trying to keep my head down, I'm trying to keep my arms stiff, okay, and I'm trying to sit on a chair, okay, and I see it all the time, and here it is.
You can say the shit channel all the time.
Yep. So this, I'm going to go from, I'm a 30 handicap golfer that has no fun playing golf. Every time I miss the ball, someone says, you peaked. They say it all the time. You peaked. So you do everything wrong, but the only thing you really worry about is you peaked. Now, if you believe that, the head starts to go more about it, okay? And then when you go over the top of it, you say, well, you gotta sit more in the chair. So that will kill you, okay? Because your arms are locked, your wrists are locked, I grab your head, and I can't even move your head because your neck is so stiff, your shoulders are so stiff that I can't move, so because everything is locked,